Mr. Excel Podcast, sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1547. Get next record. Well, hey, welcome back. It's another Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. With all this week, we're talking about this problem that Mike sent in. He has a database. He gets this data every day, pastes the data in, and then needs to print one report per record. And yesterday, in episode 1546, we set up these formulas, but then we discovered that as we delete row 2, all of the formulas change into reference errors. I'm going to do Control Z to get that back. Here's my solution, first solution for this. I'm going to insert a whole bunch of rows above where we're going to paste the data, and I'm going to copy the headings up to this special section. And because I want to make the formulas come with the data, I'm going to take this data, I'm going to cut, Control X, and then paste, Control V. And what that should do is that should force us to have our formulas now point to this row 5, the special row, instead of down here into the database. Now that I've done that, I need to get that data back into the database. So I'm going to copy and paste. So the cut is a way to have the formulas follow along. Could we have just taken the data that was previously in row 2, cut it and paste it to row 3 to have the formulas go? Yes, but then we would have had the wrong data there. That would have just been a mess. All right, so what I need to do is I need to tell Excel that we want to have the data in this special row 5 come from a different place. One way I could do is just point to the first row, copy that across, print this first record, and then point to the next row. However, if I'm going to have to do this every single day, this is going to become a very tedious thing. So I'm going to do a little bit of extra work, and I'm going to say record number, and I'm going to ask for the second record. I'm counting the headings as the first record. I'm never actually going to print that one. And right here, I'm going to build a formula that says equal index. The index function is kind of a rare function of all of these answers down here, A8 to A19, and then which row do we want? I want the second row, but I'm not going to type the 2. I'm going to click on the 2, press the F4 key. That puts the dollar signs in. That way, we're always pointing to that record number up in B1. And as I copy that across, I've now set up a cool formula that will point to a different row depending on what record number I do. So imagine this. I come in, I paste the data, today's data. I put the number 2 here and then print this printed report. I then change the 2 to a 3, and I'm now able to print the data from the second record. Print that one, change it to a 4, click print, change it to a 5, print, 6, print, 7, print, 8, print, and so on right down through the list. So this this extra row here, this row that I'm going to kind of set up once and then just keep there all the time, will allow us to navigate down through this pasted data and move the next record into our report. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.